It's a whole lot of money in this mug.
Welcome everyone to the OTC Club, hosted by myself, Christine, and Dahl, and our wonderful panel. Today on this episode, we have SPAC Trader in training. Because of technical difficulties, we were unable to catch the recording of the beginning of the podcast, but it's okay because the recording we did get, it starts where we interview SPAC, and that's everything of importance. And just to let you know, we are not financial advisors and everything is in our humble opinion. And we will see you every Sunday, 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Thank you.
I think some of Twitter might have seen it.
You opened a new room today?
Yep. It's actually pinned to my profile on Twitter. And I've just realized that after building such a good network and a good amount of people, the information overflow is sometimes like surreal, and I would like to share that with the Twitter and OTC community. So I'm going to do my best to represent the OTC community like in the coming years and hopefully full time.
Wow. Yeah, we love you for that. You know, I'm sure it's a lot of people in here and they all adore you, of course. And admire you. So let's tell us a little bit about the room that you have. Is it
open? Yeah, it's free to join for everyone. There's a link on my post. It's not really, I wouldn't call it a long room or a swing room or even like a day trade room. It's again just going to try to be a platform where I can talk freely, I would say, and you know, put out that information, because one, I don't want to be posting 50 tweets a day on Twitter, and most of the experienced and new traders kind of can tell what's going on right now in the OTC and Twitter. So, you know, looking at new avenues to get information out for the right eyes.
All right. Are you going to have a limit on how many people you allow in that room? Because some people like cap it. You know, or what are you looking for people to have in your room?
I haven't put a limit on it yet, but we do have a really solid DD team that is going to work all together. So, you know, it's going to be interesting where this can go. And I think we are near 2,000 members after opening up 3 or 4 hours ago. So it's just going to be a fun, like, first week to see how it works and adapt to a situation where I'm discussing some of the plays that I'm entering into real time.
Okay, wow. That's
amazing.
All right. Well, we have a game for you, SPAC. So, are you ready?
Always.
The game is called 5 Minute Ticker Rush. We're going to throw some tickers at you.
And these tickers came from everyone in the audience. Like, they requested us to bring up these tickers. You have 1 second to answer. It's going to be a yes, no, maybe, I don't know. And this is their tickers they're excited for this upcoming week. So they just want to know what you think about these tickers for this upcoming week. We're going to throw it at you. Yes, no, maybe, I don't know. Cool?
All right. You ready?
Yep.
You doing it, Dahl?
I don't have it up in front of me, so you go ahead and throw
it. Okay, I have it. Are you ready?
Go ahead. Let's do it.
Okay. All right, SPAC. So, GGII.
Oh, yeah.
AZFL.
Yes.
INND.
Yes.
LTNC.
Yes.
Delicious water, by the way. UBQU.
I don't know.
QBAN.
Yes.
IPSI.
I don't know.
IHSI.
I don't know.
GMND.
No.
RGVP.
Yes.
VPER.
Yes.
HCMC.
I don't know.
ENZC.
Yes.
GTEH.
I don't know.
CBBT.
No.
WTII.
Yes.
WDLF.
Yes.
FTAG.
Yes.
ILUS.
Oh, yeah.
INMD.
You can do it twice, yes.
Oh, yeah. RMRK.
Yes.
BYI.
Yes.
IMTL.
I don't know.
FBCD.
Oh, yes.
PJET.
Yes.
And the last one, WOGI.
Oh, yeah.
Dang, all right.
Okay, you're fast. He even caught the INMD twice.
I'm sorry, dude, and I tried to make sure that I did. Dude, Crown, you did that, honey. You like
that stuff. All right. It's because of Crown. Hey, man. I'm just here to listen to that.
He hacked my phone, man. He hacked my phone and put it in.
Nah, man.
All right, so let's go to some of our panel, like, have some stuff to talk to you about or want to comment. Let's go and do that. And then after that, let's go to the audience. Go ahead, guys.
Yeah, for sure. What do you think about CBDO? It's a ticker that I've been accumulating between, you know, 00012 and 13 back and forth. What do you think about it?
I certainly haven't looked into that one. Is that like the weed one, if I'm not mistaken?
Yeah. They have a lot of CBD products involving their oils, whether it's like vapes or skin products, gummies, all types of things, and their tinctures. And they're going to be on Amazon, which I know that's not a big deal because it's a huge market on there, but their spinoff with it is that their products are all extremely natural, and a lot of the other ones are not. But, you know, we hear that all the time, so I want to hear your take on it.
I mean, I think with an influx of, like, weed as a result of, like, you know, the new regulations that are going to be passed soon federally, I think it's important in any weed play to try to find a differentiator, you know. Just off, like, the top of my head, like, AZFL has that, like, Mexico connection. You know, you're talking about, like, CBD oil, so maybe patents or something like that. Like, I think it's key, also from a marketing perspective, to have a differentiator in comparison to your competition.
For sure. Absolutely.
Well, thank you, Matt. That was a good question. Can anybody else ask a question?
Yeah, I go.
Okay, Rue.
Matt, it's back. I'm going to be a millionaire this week, man. I'm in most of that stuff you said yes to. Thanks, man. But, dude, I actually started following you, ironically, because it's facts, and I found myself into the OTC world, so I appreciate you. My question for you is, when do you get out of training, and are you looking to, you know, eventually start, you know, teaching some people your skills, or how you feel about that?
Yeah, I mean, first of all, it's cool that we went on a similar journey, so definitely respect the love. But I think that I would eventually like to do it. However, you know, since I just first like found out about stocks last summer and started taking it seriously in the fall, I still think from like a financial understanding perspective, I'm still pretty far away. And the last thing that I would want to do is to sway like other people like incorrectly. So that's why I'm just trying to be like open, you know, and for example, make this room and just be like transparent with my entries, because I'm learning, like I want to be the best one day, but that's why, like, you know, I've talked to people like King and, you know, the other OGs in the game, because I still do have a lot to learn, but once I get to that stage, then yeah, it'd be awesome to like teach some people not only about good picks, but like strategies to be a winner.
Nice. Love it. Thank you, man.
All right. Who's next? West Coast Closer. You got a question?
What's up, Spac? How you doing?
What's up, man?
Thanks for doing this in your new room that that you opened up. And yeah, like I said, same with you, same with me. I started last summer or so. Like, I was doing some stocks before, more of your RSPs and then TFSA big board stuff, but when I got a hold of the OTC through a friend last summer and ended up getting on ENZC, TSMP, I've been learning from everyone from the start with all these guys. That's why what I kind of tell my followers is, you know, I'm not able to give you every angle. I'm not a professional by any means, But what I think I know a lot of these guys on this board are doing is we're just grinding. We're doing more than anyone else out there, right? Like, I don't know a chart. I can't tell you exactly how a chart's going to read. I don't have my technicals. But I'm putting in 2-3 hours a night, 8 hours on the weekend of DD to find picks. And I think that's what a lot of us are doing in the OTC. And then we learn off the chart guys, right? We all have a chart guy on our following. We use the charts that the technicals are using. And it's unbelievable how big of a Twitter family we have, and when we're all growing. And then you got guys like Crown being full leaders on the aspect of life, not just stocks. Rarely, like, he's doing the stock picks from his groups and stuff, but everyone, you know, the questions and the DMs we all get in our inboxes, which I'm sure all you guys are getting, is we're taking the time to answer them and help people and let them know. And it's truly, I didn't know anything before this and in life where I was going to be, but this has been a platform that I love, and I can't wait to continue to grow with all you guys.
Yeah, definitely. I guess just to add on to what you said, it's definitely eye-opening to see what can be achieved when there's like a commonality like between like the wants of the people involved, and I think that's like what we ultimately have. Like, we're not obviously bears, like we're not on the side of the MMs, like, and that's why I think it's so key to gather talent that's already like there existing, because without that talent, there's no way that the new generation of traders are gonna, you know, become great traders like the older generation. So it's like really cool right now to see the mix of like young traders learning from old traders with that social media aspect. I think it takes it to the next level.
Yeah, I agree with you completely. It's adapting in new and old age and everyone combining together. So thanks a lot, Spack, and keep it going. Keep it up with your platform and following. The more followers we all get, the better.
Yeah, can I add?
Thank you, man.
What?
I'm on Matt number one.
Yeah, thank you, Matt number one. West Coast closer.
I have a question. Not so much a question. What advice do you have for people that are younger than you that's just getting started in trading? What advice do you have for them?
I'd first say go and follow. That's what I tell every single new person that, you know, comes to trading. I say, like, go follow the people that I follow on Twitter. Like, I was told to follow those people by my mentors because they had time to vet them. And ultimately, like, I think I got this from Laidback, actually. But, like, you can go and do your books and go do your courses and, you know, go do psych stuff or whatever you want. But honestly, I think that the best approach for a new trader is like the trial and error process, because if this game's really for you, the mistakes are going to frustrate you and you're going to want to learn from those mistakes and correct those. So I think that the reason why I was able to adapt pretty quickly, at least in my scenario, is because of all the mistakes I made, not the victories. So I would just say, make your mistakes to new people and just don't let them knock you down, because there's always going to be another trading day. Like, you can always get another paycheck and work and, you know, work towards your financial freedom.
Amen. That was a good, that's really good for like people that are barely starting. Crown, what up, bro?
Yeah, King, yeah. What's up, King?
Man. I'm just soaking up this young brother's info, you know. I'm a student at heart. I'll never be or never feel like I am above anybody. I'm always willing to learn. I don't care how old I get. You know, that's the best way to keep going. Wow. You know, and always remain humble from your upbringings. You know, no matter what you go through, there's always somebody that can, you know, help you out left, right. It doesn't matter. You know, we all have bad days. We all lose. We all win. It's a big roller coaster, just like right now, that's happening with the market, you know, and a lot of emotions flying in the air and people pointing fingers when it's not needed, because we're all here for the same reason.
same thing I always talk about, you know, just feeding our families. And even some of us have become in stock family, you know, believe it or not, you can feel the energy. You can tell the people that really care, the people that really want to help. You know, for me, it's always a touch of matter when I see, you know, the less fortunate, or I get these messages from people that have certain type of diseases or their kids. It's an instant for me to jump on and work with the admins to bring them in the group to try to increase their revenue, because it's important. You know what I'm saying? I'm not promised tomorrow. Nobody's promised tomorrow. So all we can do is just help each other. You see what I'm saying? And I've seen people go from $1 billion to ready to commit suicide because they dropped to the millions. It's just what it is. And I think that people should be a lot more humble and just kind of just team up together, work together. You know, I see people that that are on here, like Alex. I asked him to also come on here because he comes from the big board, from the NASDAQ world, and it's good to bring them guys over to the OTC community too, because I just feel from my experience on Tested Both that with the OTC community, it's for everyone. There's no cockiness. I mean, you're talking people coming from the bottom, you know, poor, to becoming very successful out of nowhere in a matter of months. And I think that right there is why I love the OTC community, because there's no, you know, there's more people that are humble than cocky. And I think the thing that just always touches me is when, you know, a lot of people come on and bash other people and it's just negative. So, you know, I might wear my sleeve kind of high with, you know, sometimes with good emotions, nothing that's going to destroy my trades, but to stand up for everyone and let people know that you're not about to just come in and bash, especially on good plays that people worked hard for, to give good DD for days, hours, months, just for somebody to come on to destroy it. So, you know, when people tell me to, you know, kind of relax, ignore it, for the most part I do, but sometimes, you know, it's good to stand up for everyone. So, you know,
right.
So yeah, I just came on, you know, to hear my buddy speak and, you know, kind of just say what's up to everybody and hope we have a...
Can you tell Crown, like, how you and Spec, like, got together, like, know each other? Like, that's confusing to me. I'm like, you as your mentor? I'm like, wait, how?
It was funny. I remember it like yesterday. At that time, I know, like, King had, I believe, like 8,000 or 9,000 followers, and one of my friends, just like this friend that I made off Twitter, like, I always preach how I don't care about, like, your following size. Like, I literally have a bunch of friends with less than 100 followers on Twitter that I talk to on the regular just because they're got good people and good vibes. And this trader I know found, like, King's group and, like, got me, like, into King's group, like, kind of an audience. And I, like, talked to King, and we started talking about, like, growing followings, because at that time I had maybe $10,000 in my account. And I just had a networking background. My family, they had like a networking company and an advertising company. So like I was growing up on this stuff, and kind of push came to shove, started, you know, following King and his group, and just saw the ridiculous like change that they were making for so many people. So it was almost like I was shocked at his engagement rate at sub 10,000. I'm like, man, like, you have as much engagement as somebody with 100,000 followers, and you don't even have 10,000. So he kind of said that he'd be happy to mentor me and like answer my questions. And obviously I was more than helpful to, you know, lend the little bit of, let's say, status that my Twitter has to like help
bring the world to the OTC, because I mean, these returns are like nothing I've seen so far, you know, and options are a tough game. Like, not everybody is good at those. And, you know, options are sometimes the only other comparable to OTC where you can actually, you know, make a lot of money, or SPAC warrants. So I think it's a great place for people that want to make a big bang for their buck and also are risk adverse. But at the same time, like King always says, you got to be like willing to take your risks if you really want that big payout, but it's on you to do the DD and choose if that risk is worth it. So he's just been like teaching me, and his vibe just wears off the people around him, and it just makes everybody want to do better.
Wow, all those positive vibes.
Hey, man, you'll make me cry, man.
Let
me
go make me cry.
Let's all cry. Oh, man, it's raining here in Seattle, too. Man, that's great.
When is it not raining here?
It's been raining up in Vancouver all day, too.
Hey, bro, don't talk about my state, though. Come on.
King, do you have any questions for SPAC that you always wanted to ask?
You know, I think we talk a lot. Like he just randomly will ask me something at any given time. It doesn't matter. And then, you know, he's just one of those people that grew on me, because I'm all about being organic. Like, you know, just 1,000% real. Like, give it to me like DMX does, right? I'd rather you tell me everything that I need to hear than to tell me half, and then I got to find out from other people. I don't like that. I don't like sneaky people. I don't like snakes. And I feel like he just came straight up and knew what he wanted to do. He wanted to become a millionaire. And I felt like we both had something to offer each other, which was giving back to people. And he has a strong network of his family on how they network, and I do too. And I pretty much just told him that I want him to become a millionaire, just like I tell everybody else. But it was our conversations is what just sparked it. So it's hard to really ask him a question, because we talk all the time based off of just anything and everything. Sometimes it doesn't even have to be about stocks. It could just be about life and things like that.
You could also put him on the spot in front of all of us too, right? Yeah.
Go ahead.
That's all you're welcome. Go ahead.
He's just a good dude. And you know, I always give everybody the benefit of the doubt with trust, you know, and I think that's why lately I just been posting DMX, because there's a lot of things that no matter what he's done wrong for himself or to himself, he's always been good at heart to everybody else and praying for everybody else before himself. And those are the people that I love, you know, at the end of the day. And I feel like that's kind of similar things that we share, is like we do so much for the OTC community more than what people think. You know, sometimes, you know, I can be up 7 days a week, way after hours, to find out other solutions to help people outside of just wanting to give alerts. Because alerts is just one spectrum on how to succeed. That's like one quarter pie. The 75 other percent is heart, mind, and soul, and how you can overcome negativity, how you can work with others, how you can avoid a majority of these emotions that are flying, you know, when 1 minute our accounts are, you know, 10,000% up, and then the next minute it might only be at, you know, 200%, and now you're trying to figure out how to maneuver out of that. So it's good to talk to people around you in the same community that can uplift each other. That right there alone is worth way more than just alerts. And I think that's the part that I want more leaders to do. And I respect the guys like Sal and Had and SPAC and a lot of you guys that are coming in, because you guys are hungry, not just for alerts, but also you're standing up for yourself. Standing up for yourself, knowing that you're just trying to do right, and people are pointing the finger at the wrong people. You know, and I always tell people, follow actions, not words. And if you see a consistency of people, follow that. You see what I'm saying? And I think that right there is the golden ticket. And so that's why at the end of the day, for me and SPAC, we just both don't tolerate the BS. And we all are, you know, at the end of the day, we all are our own leader. And so that's why I push to everybody that I come across. If you're not already there, just keep going and create your own platform, because at the end of the day, it doesn't hurt my pockets. It only, you know, puts a smile on my face, because I know if I ever needed something, I can come to that person. I would never burn a bridge with anybody unless they come for me. So,
right. So, some spin-offs of Crowns, if you don't mind, Christine. I requested a phone call with Crown the other day. We had a conversation, and I was grateful for him to even take a 30-minute call with me, which was amazing, right? Because I started with zero followers, zero nothing. And I had to be the guy DMing people, trying to learn, trying to get respect from the GOATs and the big guys. But one thing I'll take from that as well is that it's not all about alerts. My inbox is blowing up because I think people are realizing that I'm not a professional trader. I'm currently holding about 7 to 10 stocks, and I'm doing quite well. I'm at 7 figures, and I look for 8 this year. But I think I really love this platform is because all my life's lessons, and which I think a lot of us can agree with, I'm willing to go on my phone and answer every message with complete genuine care. And that's where my following is growing, I really believe. And it's touching people on not just stocks and alerts, like Crown said. It's really giving them, you know, a mentor, someone to look up to, someone with, you know, that went through stuff, whether it's me or the next, because everyone has their life stories and everyone's struggled. And if someone can be as vulnerable and as genuine and humble to just let their guard down and answer a message, most of the messages now I get are, you're probably too busy to answer this, but, you know, I want to reach out and thank you for helping my, you know, kid's surgery that you helped pay for with your alerts, or all those things break me down. And I've been in tears several times. And it's truly a blessing, and I can't wait. I cannot wait to continue this family and grow, guys. I love it. I love it.
Oh, my God, Matt.
We're all just going to cry now.
Matt, you always do this to me. Oh, my God, just to be around men with feelings. Oh, my God.
I'm sensitive and soft.
Man, Brown and Christine is no one's real people, back. Man.
Listen,
but yeah. Hey, Bimo, we see you on here. What's up?
I want to say something about him if I can.
Go ahead, Spank.
So, like, I would just want to say that, kind of like what King was talking about, you'd be surprised that, you know, some of these, like, veterans that, you know, I don't want to talk about their, like, financial position, but they've just been doing it for a long time. It's just surprising how much they're willing to give a lending hand. And, you know, after I met King, probably the next most influential person to me in my trading game, probably besides, like, linking up with Shamar too, like, was definitely BMO. Because not only are we from a similar area, so, like, we kind of grew up with similar values, but, like, this guy, and I'm sure even, like, King just can, like, tell, like, the pull that BMO has. He's just, like, one of a kind and a must-follow for anyone. And, you know, he's a nice guy who will always set you straight and give it to you real, no matter what. And those people are rare to find, like, on Twitter. So just shout-out to BMO. Knows. He really knows.
Well, right now, I know I got a hangover from this.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. You need to calm down with all that. But I appreciate it, and I really do. Hey, man, this is awesome. This is pretty cool. I want to give all of you guys a shout out because I've been doing this for 11, almost 12 years. And when I came in the game, you know, the old heads didn't want to give us any information. The old heads didn't want to talk to us. They didn't want to help us out. And it was a cutthroat game. It was a every man for themselves type game. And you guys have come in and completely changed it. And I appreciate you guys for that. And I've always been the type of person who will reach out to anyone, or if anyone reaches out to me, you know, I will talk to someone and open up and help them out as best as I can. I've always been, I don't care if I have
5,000 followers or 200 million followers, it doesn't matter. I'm always continue to be that type of person. And what I like about you young guys, you young women coming in the game, you guys are very open, honest, and just enthusiastic about the entire process. And I love it. Like this right here, this is awesome. This is pretty awesome. And yeah, I just, man, it's refreshing. I will comment on what Crown said, because I have the same exact mentality. And I want all you guys, no matter what, you know, how much money you have, how much money you make this year, next year, stay humble. And one thing that I just absolutely hate more than anything in this game is when people bash other people or other people's plays. So whether you like that play or not, whether you like that person or not, it's not your place, because somebody has a family, somebody's money is in that play. And if you're bashing that play because you either don't like it or you're out of it or you're trying to get it lower, that's a game that none of us really have to play to succeed. And, you know, there's some people out here that still do that. And I wish that they would, you know, get rid of that. And my thing is, I literally could bash any single play, whether it's good or not. I could find one thing in the filings to bash it about. So, you know, why do that? You know, because no company is perfect. No CEO is perfect. So, you know, I just want you guys to just continue to do what you're doing. I really appreciate it. It's encouraging. It's enthusiastic. I love it. And to my man Spack, you already know, bro, we're from the same neighborhood, same area. So that's my guy. When he reached out to me, we got to talking. I found out, you know, we're from the same area. I was like, crazy. I'm like, it's a small, super small world.
Yeah.
Yeah, matter of fact, I was in Myrtle Beach this weekend. I'm chilling in the hot tub. It's a couple next to me, and we got to talking, and I found out that the couple is from the same area I'm from, and they went to the same high school as my daughter. I'm like, what the hell?
Wow.
Yeah, so that was pretty cool. And then I got them in stocks. So
so you just out here promoting stocks in the hot tub, huh?
What?
The OGC hot tub.
Pushing his plays.
I don't have to do that. Nah, come on.
Okay, we already know you don't have to do that.
Not at all.
And that last part that BMO said is that's probably, man, that's like top three most effective things that can destroy or make us is to not bash. I mean, it the energy, you know, studying psychology and energy is all I know. And I can sense it whether you're in front of me or not. And I know what can affect our stocks because they're not NASDAQ and New York Stock Exchange stocks. We don't have enough strength to hold on like that. You see what I'm saying? So word of mouth bashing, and when it spreads, people retweet it because they don't know better. You know, there's more new people than there is vets or experienced people. So, you know, when people are retweeting stuff just because it's a trend, you realize that you're affecting, just like what BMO said, you are affecting a lot of families. And that's why I preach about, you know, do this for your family and do it for the people that is out there trying to help families. So I really appreciate BMO coming on here, because I think sometimes, you know, through text and no context and no voice, you know, some vets, it's hard to tell who's prideful, who has an ego and who doesn't. And when vets can step up to the plate to speak, that right there shows much more than anything, because that's what we need more than anything right now, especially dealing with the market makers and stuff like that. And so, you know, I love that and appreciate what Brown and Christine has done to create stuff like this so people can come together and speak and actually share that organicness behind everyone speaking and actually getting a kind of a picture to this whole OTC market, and not just, you know, people's words, because people do a lot of talking and less action. And to be able to see a lot of us young cats on here that I mean, you know, I consider everybody young if you're not 60 years old. So, you know, there's just way too much money out here. That's all I can say. And when I say there's a lot of money, I'm talking athlete money. And I'm not talking the lower class athlete money. Okay, so when we all come together, you're talking a lot of money that could be spread it around for a lot of families.
There's enough for
everyone. Enough for everyone. You cannot, there's no way you can hate in stocks, because these sharks are eating off us by the billions of dollars. So when I speak that you can make a million, believe in yourself, because I've seen it and I've come from the dirt, so I know. So, you know, at the end of the day, for me, it's not really about alerts for me, because I know that I can alert, you know, 1,000 plays and people's heads will spin. I'd rather do less plays, which is more effective than doing 200-300 plays, you know, and people are lost and in the wilderness and don't know how to create financial freedom. You know, you want to focus on your day to days and then build off of that, which I call it the domino effect. And so, you know, like I said, you know, I just hope everybody learns something from SPAC. You know, SPAC, he's a good dude, and I'm glad he came on here, and definitely to speak for the young folks too, and BMO, and I do see a lot of other people on here, and you know, yeah, I just want everybody to win. So those are my words.
Yeah,
so let's win.
Thank you, King. Yeah, we're gonna win. Next up, let's start bringing some people up, Christine, and have them ask SPAC some questions.
All right, so I'm going to bring some people up. You guys have one question, and make sure to unmute your mic when you get on. And then once you ask your question, I will take you down from the platform, and SPAC will answer that to the best of his ability. If you also have any questions for anybody else on the panel, go ahead as well. So I'm going to go ahead and bring some of you on, starting with IVD. All right, IBD, go ahead. Still connecting. This was a good chat. I got teary-eyed. Again.
Hey, IBD, how you doing? What's your question?
Pretty good. How about you? One of my questions is, like, I'm pretty sure I asked Crown, like, this the last time he was on here. And just, like, you know, for people, like, new beginners and people that are just getting started in OTC, I kind of, one of my main questions is, like, what type of, like, difficulties did you come across in the OTC world, and how did you end up fixing them, or, like, and what are, like, three things, or even one main thing that you want to warn people about in OTC?
Yeah, thanks for coming on, man. I appreciate your question. I'll answer it the best I can. I mean, one thing that we all got to watch out for is, like, blowing up our account from the start, you know? I know that definitely I don't mind, like, being vocal, you know, with my own experience where, because of King, like, I got into LTNC really early and it went, like, really high. And then, like, George Sharp started bashing it, and basically just, like, as a new trader, I was unaware of the obstacles that people put up in the OTC realm. And I think that if new people learn that, you know, just because something drops is not a reason to panic, it's, like, really important. So, you know, for a new trader, I would just say that make sure to, like, study, like, what's happened in the past with tickers. If you, you know, if you're looking at a chart and you see a big sell point, find that day, figure out what happened, talk to the veterans, you know, like BMO or King, or, you know, it doesn't have to be one of the, I guess I'll say, main vets, because they have followers. Like, there's a lot of people that have experience on here that have way less followers than most of us. So just, like, keep communicating and don't get, like, shaken out by, like, a daily event when you're, like, very confident in your plays. You know, like, I think BMO and I were talking about GVSI, and when that ticker went down recently after its run, like, a lot of people ran from it,
but those that average down, you know, in the trip into the 7.8, 7.008 area were obviously rewarded because they had the experience not to get shaken out. So just like make it a habit to, like, if you do make a mistake, again, like I said before, like, learn from it, and like, you should kill it. Just be smart how you play.
Amazing. Thanks, Spec. So we have other...
You don't mind?
Okay. Go ahead, BMO.
I'll give you a quick story. 2011, I started my account trading in 2009 with about $1,000. 2011, I was up to about $55,000. And this new product came out, and it was great. Oh, it was awesome. I mean, I said, you know what? I'm going all in. I put my whole $55,000 in it. And I'll never forget, because I was still in the Air Force at the time. I was at Offutt Air Force Base in Nebraska. And I went to the casino. I was at the casino at the table. And I kept checking my account because it was growing crazy. This was a sub-penny stock. And I went all in, put all $55,000 in it. And I looked, and I was up 67,000. I looked, I was up 80,000. I looked, I was up 90,000. I was like, oh, yeah, I got it, right? Well, I looked again, and my account was down 20 grand. And I said, well, what the heck was going on? So I got backed up from the table. I looked again, and it was down to 13 grand. I'm like, well, what the heck is going on? I couldn't understand it. So back then, Twitter wasn't as big as it is now. iHub was the place that everybody went to back then.
Mm-hmm.
So I went to iHub to see what was going on and found out that the company came out with an 8K and that they were going to do a reverse split. So pretty much everybody was just dumping their stock. And by the time I put in my market sell to try to get out, I was left with about $4,500.
Okay. Wow.
So that was a little devastating. You know, I mean, I was up almost 100 grand in literally in minutes. I was down to, you know, 90% less than what I started with that day. So my advice is, and you know, I know there's people who've done it, who've gone all in plays and done well, but it only takes one time for something like that to happen that can wipe you out. So please be mindful. Do not go all in on any play, no matter how good you think it is. Don't do it. It's a recipe for disaster. That's my take. You can do what you want. That is just my advice to you. And I'm gonna get it.
That's amazing advice, because there's so many traders that will just go all in because it's running, you know? So
BMO, it happened to me, honey.
Why are you adding me right now? Why are you
adding me? He's reading me. Why are you reading me?
I mean, it happens. And I know other people it's happened to. And so I'm just, and right now, there's so many plays that are good plays. You do not need to go all in to try to, you know, you don't need to become a millionaire overnight, because it's not going to happen. In this market, it will happen if you're consistently picking winner, taking profits on the way up. You will get there. To try to get there on one play is a recipe for disaster.
Yep.
Just spin off BMO for a quick second. I'm sure a lot of people in this room got beat off this. So I made, I took some money out. I had some money when I first started, ENZC and TSMP, my first two. I bought them and held them with 10K each, and I sat there with them. And they were taking a while, and then December came around, and I had my money in there. I was willing to sit with it, and I saw this ARCS. I saw this hype that everyone knows about. And I was still new a little bit. I jumped and took $1 million off each play. So off both those plays that would have been worth millions, and I put it in. It was like 50K on ARCS. Watched it run up to 8 cents. The girlfriend told me, sell, let's take profits. I said, no, this is going bigger. It's a big, big cannabis play. I didn't do any DV. I just jumped in it. Never again have I done that. The next day, that night, caveat emptor, I sold it 80K for, I think, 1500. So I agree. Oh, wow. Do not jump to the next best thing until you do your quick DD. Because I was still young then and new and not young, new, but awful.
Oh, well, I think we've all, a lot of us have learned like a big lesson like that. Not as big as some of you, but it's definitely good advice for new traders. So we're making the mistakes here so you guys don't have to.
Yeah.
And I'm going to go to next.
Yeah. One thing I just wanted to add is it's important for traders to have accountability. stop blaming everybody for the mistakes that you make. It's not everybody else's fault. You need to just trade better. And I say this every spaces. Learn from your mistakes. Learn from your mistakes. That's the most important lesson to me, is just learning from your mistakes and holding yourself accountable for your trades. And yeah, that's pretty much all I have this time.
For now. All right, I'm gonna go to the next question. It's from Elaine. I went ahead and approved her. She's connecting, or he. Elaine, go ahead. Elaine, you're muted. Go ahead.
Hey, Christine. Hey, Brown. Thank you so much for this room. Hey, Spack. Thank you so much for your time. My question is not a serious question at all. My question is, what is your go-to meal after a really hard red day?
After a really hard red day, huh? Well, everybody's their own person, right? Like, some people say that, you know, on the red days, you should, like, go and actually eat well, you know, because it's, like, an offset. But, like, personally, the way that I treat it is, like, if I don't bring home, like, the bread to the table, then, like, I'm not eating as good. So, like, you know, I might literally go to, like, I don't know, like, Wendy's or Chick-fil-A or something, like, crappy, or, you know, I don't want to call it crappy, but, like, fast food on a red day. But then, you know, as I'm sure some of you guys have seen, when I do have a green day,
We've all seen.
So, yeah, I mean, I think it's just dependent, but for me, on a red day, I kind of just like to, like, get right back to the book and figure out how to get green the next day. So, the food doesn't cross my mind as much.
Yeah, let's not talk about Spack's food right now. He's been posting. This is ridiculous.
All right. King Trades has a question. Go ahead, King Trades.
Hey, it's not really a question, but I'll just say thanks for having a little group meeting. And, just, you know, just to hit up on what Emo said, I started trading about 10 years ago, too, and the only thing we had was IHOP. It was pretty cutthroat, I'm not gonna lie. I used to be a basher when I first started, because it was just, that's all that you could do to get cheap shares. And I started using trading tools and hopped on Twitter a little bit later. But yeah, I like what y'all are doing. I like the family vibe and different awesome. Making spread and stuff like that. But yeah, that's all I had to say. Appreciate it, y'all.
King Trades, thank you.
Thanks, King Trades.
All right, so.
Thanks, my man.
How many more do we have? Do you guys want to do? Spec?
I mean, I'm.
Go ahead and bring one more up.
Yeah, whatever you get is best. All right.
Let me see. There's a few, bro. There's like 20, so I'm going to do an eeny, meeny, miny, moe.
Eeny, meeny, miny, moe.
All right, Nadia. Let's see. Nadia connecting. She has a question for you. After hers, we'll go ahead and close it out.
Hey, Nadia. Hello. Hi, Spec. So, quick question. You're a fairly young guy. You've accumulated a great amount of success within a short period of time. Now, my question is, what keeps you up at night regarding the OTC universe, and what solutions are you putting in place to resolve those items?
I mean, honestly, like, I feel like if I can potentially grow a platform, you know, in such a short amount of time, then there's really no reason why, like, anybody else can't accomplish anything, especially, like, coming as a new person, like, to, you know, the OTC or just trading. So, like, I guess the things that I want to put into play, and why I'm always, like, trying to post, like, motivational quotes and, like, memes and, like, just trying to, like, create this, like, happy atmosphere that people can call work on a daily basis. Because for me, like, this is the best damn job I've ever done in my life. And, like, I want to bring that energy to other people. So, like, that's what I try to, like, set into play. And, like, King and some other people know about, like, some of the crap that I've been, like, through, like, in my life, and
you know, there's just like no time for that negativity. So I just try to like bring my A game every day and try to be funny, even if I'm the only one laughing sometimes. But hey, you know, so yeah.
Well, that's awesome. Well, it's been amazing, and we have a great panel here today. I want to thank Spag for being our guest, King, Nemo, Matt 1, Matt 2, Rue, for being on the panel. Do you guys have anything you want to say before we head out? Go ahead.
Matt, I would love to say something, if you guys don't mind. The energy in the OTC is amazing, because before I got in here, people used to make it seem like it was kind of like a shark's den, and I was kind of skeptical about trading. And honestly, like, just following the right people, they say really if your experience on social media is based off of who you follow, and that's very true, because I've had to adjust a few times myself, and you know, getting to be able to follow the right people has really opened up the door for me and made it a great experience. So I really just appreciate you guys and your energy and just the constant positivity.
Well, Rue, you know, we appreciate you and everything that you do for the OTC Club. Anybody else?
I'll say one thing. I'm getting a lot of DMs as well, and I think a lot can agree right now, guys, especially with the smaller bankroll people, and Crown and other can agree, is they're sending me, they're asking, how can I build my account fast? And then I get this screenshot of 40 plays in the red right now in the OTC. Guys, you got to narrow your plays. Like, I went from 50 in the heart of February when the OTC was hot and nothing could miss to narrow down to 7 right now. And I buy in, I swing, I day trade a little bit. But literally, that's all I can say is narrow your plays. Cut your bags. The ones that don't have near-term catalysts are not just going to magically run. Don't hope that red. And it's not saying that the longs that are, you know, taking a beating from MMs will not run. As long as you got in at a low trips or a good entry, but just narrow your plays, guys. Like, and I'll say that to the audiences. You can't think they're all running right now with the OTC because they got a hold of us. So narrow your plays, guys. Be smart. And pick your gems and rinse and repeat, shave off the top and add your reds. Cheers.
Absolutely. I do have a little something to say. I've been honestly sitting in the shadows here. I definitely do not ever want to be the smartest person in the room. And what's been put together by the both of you is so beautiful. Like, there are so many knowledgeable sources in here that need to be followed, and you know, they're willing to give the time, and I'm willing to give the time, and it's something beautiful. But there are two things that really I want to reiterate that has been said that really hit me is first being, do not go all in on one play. Long story short, loaded 6 figures on ONTX way back, got blown up. You know, playing a phase 3, I was going to play the news. Well, the news came two weeks earlier than I anticipated, and I was caught with my pants down, you know. And it absolutely blew my account up. And I took a few months off of trading, really started getting in tune with working out and just attacking it, you know, myself. And now I'm really, you know, successful again. But definitely do not load your account. I'll leave you with that. Do not load your account.
Well, thank you, Daddy.
What I want to end with is everybody. Practice your awareness. It's almost like when you drive, and a lot of people only look forward and never look left, right, behind. Or when you're walking, you don't watch your surroundings. Always, and like, I'll say this a million times, practice your awareness. Like, learn how to be aware of everything that's happening around the OTC market. That alone will sharpen your financial skills when it comes to how to increase, knowing how to go from 9 plays back up to 20, then drop to 15, knowing how to manage your account and your personal life at the same time. That alone will make you 007 in this game. You know what I'm saying? Because everybody feeds off of their personal life. And a lot of emergencies will happen where you have to snatch from your shares. So you have to know about the awareness, because we all have been burnt before. But those mistakes is what makes you A1. And learn from those mistakes. Yep. That right there is pretty much what I'd say. It's just practice your awareness in the OTC and also know who to follow and who not to follow. So.
Yeah, for sure.
Hey, guys.
Yes.
You might have to add something to what Matt and Crown actually brought up. It was a good point. Matt said he took off some time. And I think a lot of people also struggle, at least from my experience, is knowing when to take time for yourself to, like, readjust, especially when it's a bad week or a bad month or whatever, you know, those red days come. Like, understand that you're still human and you need to take time and don't force things, because a lot of people struggle with that. They force plays, and it just ends up being detrimental to them, and it discourages them. So understand, like, what you need to do and to reevaluate and, you know, again, become a better trader by learning. So don't ever force. So I got it.
I'm going to spin off that and then Crowns as well. So my girlfriend the other day as well, and I listened to a Kevin O'Leary skit where it said, and Kevin O'Leary, the guy said, so I have this, he's an entrepreneur, developed this crazy business, putting in 20 hours a day, built, you have to pick the startup or me. He said, you're putting too much time in. And he called Kevin O'Leary, and Kevin O'Leary said, well, what can you do? Find a new startup or a new wife? And I'm not saying leave your wife, leave whatever. What I'm saying is, this millions are not going to come free, guys. They're not just going to come by you following a guy on Twitter, jumping on an alert. You're going to get bagged. You know, even my girlfriend said, you're putting a lot of time in this. I said, well, also my lawyer buddies who make $300K a year but put 15 hours a day in, I'm not just going to make 10 or 8 figures by putting in an hour a day studying. And I'm just, so stay in your lane. If you want to make 5 figures, then make 5. But if you want to make, so someone else messaged me, if you want to make a million, you have to put the time in. You can't just expect to grow it. So whatever you want to do, guys, either way, this isn't free money. It's hard work. It's time. It's DD. It's knowing what you have. And truly, truly going for it. So trust that, and wherever you want to go, guys, this is it. The OTC Crown, this is it, guys. You can work as hard as you want. This is how you can make generational wealth. I was in debt 100K in September, and I took a line of credit out. Don't recommend it. I said,
I remember you told me this.
I took 30K into millions, but I don't recommend taking debt on this, but. But I took the time. I studied every night, and that's why, you know, that's why we're getting where we are, guys. Put the time in. That's all I say. Don't expect it if you're not going to put the time in.
Yep. The more time you put in, the more money you make, like with everything else.
Yeah. Right. Trust me, me and Christine are up all night talking to each other, and she gets on me because I'm up so much. It's affecting everything around me. But I just want to say thank you to everybody for joining. I know you guys love us so much that you just want to stay in here and talk to us all day. But feel free to inbox me. I answer those.
I want to say thank you, too. Make sure you guys follow everyone on the panel today. BMO, Crown, of course, our special guest, Spac. Matt, the two Matts, West Coast Matt and Matt. And Rue. So go ahead and give us a follow, especially the OTC Club. Guys, we will be holding the chat on the OTC Club soon as Twitter lets off of the beta and lets the OTC Club do it. But until then, me and Doll will be holding it on our profiles. Spec, do you have anything to close off with before we let everybody go?
I guess, you know, for some, even if it was a financially strong 2020 with how, like, hot things were, I'm sure COVID affected most of us poorly. And, you know, people can talk about, like, working together, but actually taking that step and working together for real is, like, the hard part. And the more people that we have down for that, the greater impact we can make. So, you know, that's what I'll say.
Amazing. Guys, and this is the first one where attempting to record, so this will be uploaded if everything went smooth on the recording. And upcoming in our calendar, we do have Crown King up to come on soon. We'll announce the dates. We have Raj coming up. We'd love to have more people, so we will be approaching a lot of people like BMO as well. So go ahead and give the OTC Club follow and the Yep. And we will see you guys next Sunday, 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Everyone, thank you so much. Everyone to the panel, thank you, Spack and BMO.
Thank you, Matt. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, guys. Love you. Christine and Doll, you guys are amazing. Thank you for putting that job platform. What a platform.